So you can actually save data between attempts. Here's an example. And the walls are gonna stay gone until you completely exit and re-enter the level. Now it's reset. And the trick that this is abusing is actually very, very easy. So let's make a new level. And there are some objects in this game that have hitboxes, right? And if we scale them into the negatives, there's actually something interesting that's happening. It's that their hitboxes are now little small dots, and they're always like in the top right of their actual hitbox. If we play the level like this, we don't touch the little dots and we don't interact with the spike and the portal. Of course, if you touch the little dots, which are the new hitboxes, you still interact with the objects. So what is interesting about this is that if you rotate these in these negatively scaled objects, but it doesn't matter which amounts you rotate this by, if you rotate them, their hitboxes are going to be reset to the normal hitboxes again. So while last time I could phase through these guys, their hitboxes now reset because of the rotation. And yeah, now I die to this. And I know it still shows only those small dots right here, but trust me, it's the actual hitbox. It's just some, I don't know, visual error. So now the data saving thing comes into place. So if you put this rotation trigger behind these objects, we can see it way more easily. So we phase through this, then we passed the rotation trigger, which reset the hitboxes of those objects. And if we restart now, the hitboxes are still reset. So that resetting of those hitboxes is being saved throughout multiple attempts. And that is a unique property of the negatively scaled objects. So basically, using negatively scaled objects and rotation, you can save stuff throughout multiple attempts. And you can do this with touch triggers as well, which is so powerful. That's a super powerful tool. And I'm just gonna show that or demonstrate that by replicating the example from the beginning. So let's give this wall group ID 2. Then this guy toggles group ID 2, but only if it's touch triggered. And then we scale it negatively. And I'm gonna make it very, very big. We don't hit the little spot, so it's not possible to hit the little hitbox with the cube by jumping. And then we need to give this guy group ID 1, so it gets rotated and the hitbox gets reset. And basically what should happen now is we spawn, we don't activate this because of the negative hitbox, then we pass the rotation trigger, which resets the hitbox, then we die, and then we respawn, and we hit the reset hitbox, and then the wall should be disappeared, should be gone. So let's try it. And now the wall is gone. And yeah, that's pretty much how it works. You can do this with all the triggers, like the spawn trigger and whatever, as long as it's touch triggered, of course, and negatively scaled. By the way, you can also chain these. So if I copy paste this and build helper this, it actually works in multiple steps now. There's just so much stuff that you can do with this. It's a very, very powerful tool. And yeah, that's pretty much the trick. Have fun.